What's going on YouTube, BrummyAdz today? Welcome back to more Red Dead Redemption 2, the walkthrough. Let's get straight into it. I'm almost at the mission now. Almost there. I got across. Should be able to. One button. Oh, something else, one.
I just don't understand this at all. Hey, over here.
Say it once.
What's the problem?
Problem? No, there's no problem. Quite the contrary. Well, there is a problem. For me, but not for you.
All right. I ain't got time for
no,
this.
No, wait! Give me a minute of your life. I might just change it forever. I'm sure you will have heard of me. Máximo Cristóbal Valdespino, the renowned explorer.
Can't say I have.
There has been much written about me. I once had high tea with the Viceroy of India. I helped liberate South America. I've climbed mountains and swum across seas. I have had many women. I've spent the last 3 months hunting treasure on the American frontier. Beautiful country. Reminds me a lot of Almeria. But tomorrow I set sail for the island of Shikoku in the Japanese archipelago in search of the legendary Tokushima Sapphire.
Well, good for you.
No, hold on. You see this map here? It was made by the Jackal Gang. They robbed banks all the way from here to California.
Yeah, I know who the Jackal Gang are.
Oh, them you have heard of. But me? Rumor has it they buried gold somewhere in this area, but were killed before they could retrieve it. They created two maps to ensure it was well hidden. This is the first and should lead you to the second. You just need to follow the landmarks drawn here.
Me?
Yes! Unfortunately, I am out of time now, but I am prepared to sell it to you for the low price of $10. A trifling investment for a man such as you, given the potential returns.
Well, I'm interested in the map, but not so interested in the haggle. Why don't you just hand it over instead?
Yes, you are funny. Hey, what is your problem?
Hey. Thanks for the hat. Make it look like he had a tumble off a cliff. If I can. Alright, let's go then. Let's back to the mission. So I'll say someone will find you soon. Oh, will the horse be back there? I do the mission? Probably not. Drinking can I make some money for all taking that place, but it's obviously too far to travel.
What's the hold up? Mr. Morgan, I took your advice, sir. I took your advice.
Then your god has finally deserted you. What you talking about?
I took your advice, sir. I have removed myself from Morpheus's embrace. No more shall I sink, sir. I'm free. I am free.
You don't seem free, friend. You seem drunk.
Sit down, Reverend. We ain't finished.
You ain't finished. Look at him. He's finished.
None of us force liquor down his throat. Friend, I just want him to play.
Now, firstly, we ain't friends. Don't make no mistake on that subject. Now, secondly, he can't hardly see, let alone reason. Now, reasoning ain't never been one of my strong points, neither, but seeing I do just fine. You want to step outside or do a business here?
I just want him to finish the game.
Why can't we all just get along? These are good men, Arthur. They're children of God. They are children of God.
Oh. How's about you playing this place, huh? That seems fair.
Fair?
Sure.
Oh, great.
You want a game?
Sure. I'll play a few hands.
Well, sit yourself down.
I don't play cards, not even in real life.
I'm Luther. This is Marvin.
Fortunate for you both for being gentlemen about this.
Same goes for you.
Got a queen and a ten.
Now you two know each other anyway. Don't seem like the likeliest of friends, if you don't mind me saying.
We go a long way back.
And now you're his chaperone?
I guess it's something like that. Can we play?
I check.
He can't be no real clergyman. He committed about 5 cardinal sins just in that chair you're sitting in.
I think he used to be. He's drifted a little in recent years. And life is a challenge to all of us.
Can you imagine him at the pulpit? If he could stand up.
On the 4th day, he turned water into whiskey, and I don't remember much after that.
He's a decent fella going through a bad time. Disrespect him again, and you'll find yourself in a bad time, too.
All right, all right. Just trying to have a little fun here. It is a game, after all, mister. Better than nothing.
Fair enough.
Gonna start small here.
Is that it?
Clue what I'm doing. So we got half each.
Halves it is then.
Leave, because I want to get on the missions.
Gentlemen, this is getting too rich for me.
Sit down.
Oh, I'm done, friend. It's been a real education. Come on, Rip. Where is he? Where'd he go?
Who?
The Reverend. Where is... Excuse me, gentlemen.
Oh, I've got to find him.
Reverend Swanson! Where'd you go?
I have to fight. Oh, the circle in it, yeah.
I'll kill you both!
Oh, fair enough, he's kicking my ass.
You bastard! Oh my god, killed him! I'm gonna get the law on you!
Oh, bugger.
Hey, you! Get back here! Now what? Where's Reverend?
Drunk, I'm walking across the bridge. Crazy?
Off a bridge like
there
that.
Was a goddamn train, you crazy bastard!
Have I been bad again, Mr. Morgan? I'm sorry. I wish I was different.
Let's get you home.
Home? Yeah, that's a wonderful idea. I could have tea with Margaret.
Margaret? Who's Margaret?
But...
Don't be sick of my horse. I'm thinking that it sounds like we're back home. Mr. Marston there. Yeah, looks like it. Just ran on the floor.
Your way to salvation, my friend.
What happened?
Just usual.
Poor bastard.
Exactly.
Well, thank you, Mr. Morgan. I'll keep an eye on him.
He was lucky this time. Real lucky.
Alright, that's that mission done. Next mission. Which one do I do now? Are they Paul Strauss over there? Oh no, it's not there. Oh. Yeah. Let's go over there because it's not too far.
Everything you need, Miss Grimshaw?
Not by a long shot, Mr. Morgan. We lost a lot of money.
We'll be back on our feet soon.
What's going on now?
Hey, what's with the holler?
Please help me! Oh. knife and... All right.
Quit moaning. Christ.
Oh, God. I look so wrong.
Let's keep this between us.
Oh, you saved my life. I owe you.
Not that right.
I do. Now I gotta get out of here. God. There's so much like it around here no more.
Glad I could help. Keep your eyes on the ground, huh?
I got love this time.
Oh, Mr. Downs! Downs! Where are you?
Good job, girl.
Thomas Downs!
I have both. Sweet.
Mr. Thomas Downs?
Yep, that's me.
You owe me money.
No, I'm...
We ain't a charity, Mr. Downs. Oh, come here, you maggot.
Please, sir.
Really? Threaten me, would you?
Please. I have a family, sir. Please.
I don't care about your family.
Why'd it have to come to this, huh?
Believe me, sir. I didn't want this either.
You ain't such a do-gooder, are you? If you're running out on debts...
I'm not running anywhere. I'm doing my best for you.
You are a slippery little bastard. I got you now.
Please, show some compassion. Please.
Strauss told me you needed a beating. You saying he was right?
What will that solve?
If you'd been good, this wouldn't be happening. We took your word. Now we'll take your hide.
Please, no.
You borrowed money from my business partner, Herr Strauss. You owe him, you took the money. He wants it back, what's not to understand? Where's our money?
I don't have it.
Sell your place.
We already owe more than it's worth.
Then sell your wife, or your family, or something. We ain't your idea of charity. Is that clear?
Thomas!
What are you looking at?
Thomas!
I said, what you looking at, woman?
My husband isn't well. If we could just have more...
Like I said, we ain't nobody's idea of charity. Get us the money.
Thank you. back here. I just have to do it myself, that's one thing. I'll hitch my horse real quick. Oh no, no, slow down.
Did you get on?
Not so good. He's almost dead. And they seem more or less destitute. You were a fool for lending them the money.
Well, people who aren't desperate don't seem so interested in my propositions.
Of course.
Where to now? I've got quite a way to go when I'm over there. Yeah, I'll probably go to him because that's closer. And I'm wanted there. Let's grab the horse.
Okay, well, let's talk more later.
We'll see you later.
Let's go, girl.
I'm gonna wait. Hang on. Yeah, I'm gonna cut the video out for now until I get there. Do that one first. And there, and then there.
Yep.
I'm gonna wait for the mission for a while, getting the other ones done. I'm gonna cut the video out for now until I get there. See you later, guys. If you like the video so far, please like and subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay up to date with all my content. See you soon. Money, can't complain. I'm almost there. Sunlight shining on my TV from the other room.
Come on, girl.
Someone there.
You chick Matthews.
Oh, no, no, not me, sir. That's the greenhorn over there. Oh, and there he goes.
So long, long shark.
Damn it. Hey, get back here. You owe us money. Yeah.
Next time, pay up. Right, where's we now? Well, I ain't shut up yet.
Yep.
Oh, I've got to find him. Okay. Just kill something. deliver it back while I can. Alright, next one. And then first. Alright, let's go here next. Lily. What does it say? Lily Minute.
Such a goddamn performance with you. Now, I told you I'd get you the money next week, and I'll get it.
If you didn't make it this week, who's to say you'll make it next?
Don't you take that tone.
Lily, where's our money?
What?
That loan you took. It's payday.
I'm sorry. I don't have it right now.
Well, then, I guess we got a big problem, don't we?
Cooper, give him what you've got.
I ain't giving him nothing. Except a lesson, you damn murderer!
Son of a bitch!
Maybe drop my hat.
Leave me alone, won't you? You've got the debt.
I didn't steal that. It's a debt. Damn it.
What do you want? I've got nothing to say to you.
Set you free and you do anything, I'll kill you.
What did
you
I
ain't
do,
scared
huh?
Nobody.
Alright, let's go to my mission now. Which is, ain't too far, from here. Stop video for now until I get there.
Yeah.
See you in a sec, guys. Just as I'm leaving, it comes back up again. Alright, where is he? Over there?
It's an interesting way of putting it, Seamus.
No doubt. I do interesting very well. It's trusting I don't do so well.
Oh, please.
This is Seamus. He's our new partner.
I ain't no such thing.
Prospective new partner, if he likes this.
Liking ain't the problem. Trusting is, as I said.
Keep your voices down.
I don't want my boss here. This is a sideline.
Of course. Look at us. Honest as the day is long.
Exactly.
I tell you what. Let us prove ourselves.
Prove ourselves? To this clown? What you talking about?
Good day, Hosea. Good luck with your business dealings.
Listen. He's rough and ready and quick with his tongue, but I swear you can trust him and trust me.
I'm an old man.
You're not old, Seamus.
I'm old enough. And you know why I ain't dead?
You don't trust idiots.
Exactly.
We're not idiots. Let us prove it to you.
Okay. I'll tell you what.
Arthur!
Old Bob Crawford and his boys just bought a beautiful stolen stagecoach from upstate. It's in their barn. Now you go get that. And then we can work together.
Who's old Bob Crawford?
An acquaintance of mine.
So you want us to take out your competition?
Well, he's not just an acquaintance, but a cousin. By marriage. I also want to see if you boys got what it takes. Well, you survived that.
Where is he?
Well, he's in a farmhouse just northwest of here called Carmel de Dell. It's just up the train tracks as you're heading up towards Fort Wallace. There's also some money in that house, but that's your business, not mine. But don't kill nobody. Folks know we ain't intimate no more, and they'll know it was me.
But you're fine with us robbing your cousin.
By marriage. And yes, I love it.
You heard the man. Let's go rob his cousin.
By marriage.
Oh, dear.
Really?
Really. Lead the way. He said the place is just northwest of here.
Me?
The other one who's been out gallivanting around here.
That's what you call it. Clearly you've recovered from your bear encounter. Yeah.
Could have played that better, couldn't you?
Thought you wanted me here to show some strong arm. That's usually how it goes.
Yes, but you know how this works.
Come on, Jose. That feller's a joke.
And that's why he's perfect. He won't cause us any problems. A safe spot to fence wagons and coaches, that's easy money for us.
I guess you're right.
Come on, it's not like he's asking us to rob a bank. If the two of us can't steal a stagecoach from Seamus's old crooked cousin by marriage, we should hang up our hats now. Up ahead. We should go on foot from here. Let's see what we're dealing with. Come on.
Oh, I left a hat.
There's the house. You see the barn in the back. Stagecoach has to be in there.
I just noticed that.
Okay, let's take a quick look at the place.
Anyone around?
Yes. Okay. I reckon we can do it now. I'll head over, distract him by putting on a little show where you sneak into the house, find what you can, then get the stagecoach. Or wait until nightfall. Sneak in, then I'll get the coach. You can try the house. What do you think?
Do it now.
Let's do it now.
Sure. All right, then. Don't follow me.
Thank you.
He is. I was lost many years. Now I'm not. And you know what? Oh, here he is. Are you the father of the house?
Sure.
Pleasure to meet you. I just got him with Junior here. You selling something for me? Really?
Okay, let's grab this stagecoach and get out of here.
Yep.
That was too easy.
Damn it! I think you should have been more careful.
Yeah, sorry. I must have left the dresser open.
Slow it down a bit.
No.
What were you able to lift from the house?
Found some money stashed away. Must be a few hundred, not too bad.
Not bad at all.
This was easier than hunting a 1,000-pound grizzly, anyway.
Get back on the path. No doubt. I won't forget that in a hurry.
I'm looking forward to your retelling of that one around the campfire.
Hey, slow it down. It wasn't the first time Mr. Matthews had stared death in the eye. And as usual, he did not flinch.
Yeah, exactly. You're out here for
it. You're gonna crash if you don't slow down.
Oh,
okay, here we are. Just pull the coach into the barn there. Hello, Seamus. We met your cousins.
How was it?
Fine. Nice people.
Park that thing in here. Quickly.
Nice work, Hosea. It was mostly art. Like I said, coarse, but competent.
Here.
Thank you.
If you find any other coaches that need selling, I'll see what I can offer you for. But discreet, you know.
Of course. Goodbye, gentlemen. I'm heading back to camp, I think. You coming?
Sure.
Go ahead that way anyway, so I did it myself.
Dear Arthur, I've written this letter 100 times or more, and I cannot get it right. It's me. You know it's me from the bad handwriting. I know I said when we last spoke, and I was going off to get married, that we would not speak again. I know I said a lot of things, and I meant them, I suppose, at the time. But I'm not so proud as to not speak to people who care for me, or cared for me. I've been in Valentine for a couple of months. I had some bad luck, and, well, it's a long story and not an interesting one, but I am here for now. I saw a couple of the girls, or whatever the polite term is for them, that ran with you and your associates in town, and I heard tell of a man who sounded like you. I would love to see you again. If you could spare me a little bit of your time. I'm renting a room at Chadwick Farm, just north of Valentine. Yours, Mary Linton.
But answer me this. If Miller is a fraud, is he an honest fraud?
The way I see it...
Morning, Arthur.
He's the worst kind of fraud,
what's
Mr.
Wrong?
Dutch.
Thought
he's a rich dream of playing and being one of us.
How do you mean?
I don't know.
He's on vacation with the lower classes. The outlaws, those unprotected by wealth.
You are too hard on him. He writes with incredible beauty.
Yes. He's very ornamental, as my uncle would say.
And your uncle? What was he?
He was a slave. Most educated man in his county. But a slave.
Miller writes about men like him.
Miller's a slave, too. A slave to pretty words and empty phrases, but he don't understand.
You are too harsh a critic.
Look, you're a great man, Mr. Dutch. But you ain't great because of Evelyn Miller.
Keep quiet, Morgan. He'll eat you alive. It ain't difficult.
Careful now, Denny.
I didn't mean to do that. Let's quickly get this done.
Yes?
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to disturb you, ma'am. Is Mrs. Linton in?
I'll go see.
Mrs. Linton, a caller for you.
Hello, Arthur.
Mary?
I heard you and your friends was around.
Okay. There's them. Where's what's-his-name?
Died.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, me too. Me too. Happened a while ago. Pneumonia.
Bad business.
Sure.
So, you've been made a widow and you come here looking for me, is that it?
No, ain't like that, Arthur.
Oh, okay.
Listen, Arthur, my family. I need your help.
You mean the family that always looked down on me? You want me to help?
It's my little brother, Jamie.
I always liked Jamie, at least compared to the rest of them.
He's broken Daddy's heart.
Daddy has a heart.
Don't make me beg you, Arthur.
My money, my life, me. I wasn't good enough.
I'm sorry. We need your help real bad. Little Jamie's joined the Chelonians, that strange religious order.
Oh, wait, him.
They're quite mad, Arthur. They'll kill him. You're the only person he'd listen to.
I saw him on this.
I'm too rough to marry into your family, but it's okay to ask me to help and save him, your family.
I'm sorry. I understand if you don't want to help me, but I think of you often.
A long time ago now.
I'm begging you, Arthur.
I say let Jamie live Jamie's life, and not the nightmare that his daddy dreamed up for him.
Jamie's so innocent, Arthur. Please, Arthur. Will you help me?
Where is
it? Somewhere out near Carmody Dell, I think. The rancher there said he'd seen him around the Cumberland Forest. I just want him back, Arthur. If you find him, bring him to me at the station.
I'll see what I can do.
I'll owe you.
You already owe me.
Quick. What do I know? All the way over there. You serious? Well, it's not too far. Right, let's get it done. Not the best in Call of Duty then.
me twisted my ankle something fierce. Think you could give me a ride?
Yeah, sure. Hop on.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Trish trying to be just ran.
You know Emerald Ranch? Mind taking me there?
Yeah, sure.
Glad I ran into you. I raised that horse, you know. Raised it since it was just a foal.
Losing a horse is hard. Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, that horse did right by me. Better than my husband, truth be told. That fool. Always complaining. But does he do something about it? Man barely lifts his hand to wave the flies away. Aside from to lift a drink, of course. Marriage, for me, has been nothing but trouble. But Biscuit, he was a fine animal. Loyal, smart, brave. Didn't take no guff, not from no one. Had one of them mountain boys pull a gun on me once. I was riding up near the Dakota and had stopped by a nice warm patch. Must have dozed off, but I wake up and find some nasty piece of work pointing a rusty shotgun straight at me. Well, he gets wheezing on, and I must have made some sort of noise, because the next thing I know, Biscuit had nipped his ear clean off. Kicked his hide, too, as he was hollering away. Didn't think a man could run so fast.
Oh, yeah? Yeah.
Yeah, had a good laugh on that one. I tell the husband, what does he do? Should have never gone over there, honey, he says. Gee, thanks.
So, you live at Emerald Ranch then?
For the time being. I was looking for work. They was looking for some help with the gardens. If I waited any longer for my husband to put food on the table, I'd have died of starvation. I'll be moving on soon, though. Emerald Ranch, well, it's a strange place.
How so?
The owner's a mean bastard. Strange, too. Delights in bullying folk. There's a daughter, but she never leaves the house. You can see her in the window sometimes. When I asked about her, everybody told me to leave it alone. Found an old saloon there, all shut down now, but I went in to have a look, and there's bullet holes, old blood stains. Something definitely happened there, but I couldn't figure it. Just an uncomfortable feeling to the place. Either way, it's time I left. Especially now I lost that poor horse. I'll collect my belongings and be on my way. Please, quit riding like this!
I'm gonna shoot you.
Back home?
Oh, we're getting close now.
Left beating track to run in the open.
Here we go. This is great. This was kind of you, mister. Please take this as my way of thanking you. Appreciate it. What a lousy day.
Alright. How far have I got to do? All the way up there. Oh, great. That's long. I'm going to cut it out for now and I'll start the corner when I get across. Is this an occult mission? I sort of remember this bit. Give it a
speak to the boy?
Arthur?
Hello, son. Your sister is very worried.
The boy has chosen a path, sir. A path to truth.
Well, his sister just wants to speak with him.
Arthur, I've chosen a path.
The boy has chosen a path. He's chosen safety. What path have you chosen, sir?
I don't know about this nonsense. Let me speak to the boy.
Dut-dut. Are you always this negative and antagonistic, sir?
I'm not a very cultured man. Forgive me, please.
I am a fool for my God and a happy one, sir. I bless you. What do I dream about? Who are my heroes?
I have no idea. Turtles. Yeah, turtles. Hey, you love turtles? I love them too. Turtles.
Jamie knows the truth. But of course, you may speak with him.
Exactly. If your teachings are so great, what harm can I do?
I'm not coming with you, Arthur!
Just come and speak with Mary, then make up your mind!
Leave me alone, Arthur! I didn't ask for your help!
Oh, I've always got to chase someone. I'm not gonna copyright me for this music. Out of stamina. There's only there in front of me.
Thank you.
might work, but yeah. I was trying to cut him off going that way because that's where he was going to go anyway. That kid's got a fast horse. He's right there. Why is it failing me when it's twice I got there now? It's been right in front of me. Oh, bear with me guys, I will get through it. You know me.
What the hell are you doing?
Arthur! I'm a man now! I found something! A calling!
You're just a kid! You're making a big mistake!
I'm not taking advice from you! You're an outlaw! You leave me alone! They're good people! I'm warning you, Arthur Morgan! Leave me alone!
Please, kid. Put that gun down.
I warn you, Arthur! I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone!
Now calm down! Let's go see your sister.
Okay.
Okay. What the hell?
Okay, kid.
Have I been a terrible fool, Arthur?
I don't know. I don't know enough about it. But one thing I do know. There ain't no shame in looking for a better world.
I missed you, Arthur. Are you and Mary sweet on one another again?
Oh, no. That's all a long time ago.
Yep.
Well, this wasn't how I thought today would turn out.
It's been a long time, Jamie Gillis. You were a kid last time I saw you. You didn't try to kill yourself.
You know, you taught me how to ride a horse.
Too well, apparently. Slonia, though. Really? You fall for that?
They were very nice to me. They're decent.
I'm sure. Please tell me you didn't give them any money.
Of course I did. They rely on charitable donations.
Jesus, Jamie, come on.
I just wanted to believe that there might be something good coming my way one day. Guess that's dead in the water.
With the turtle.
Shut up. All Father kept telling me was, you won't amount to anything. You're not enough of a man. I had to get away. I couldn't take it anymore.
Forgive me, but your father's a bully and a coward.
My God!
Oops.
You taught me how to ride.
So you was just talking about something?
Hey, don't talk about him like that.
What do you want me to say, Jamie? He's your good father.
What are you putting a gun for?
Nice man.
He won't be happy I saw you.
Please send him my worst regards.
The thing is, he's right. I'm not good at anything.
Come on, that ain't true. Tell me something you like. Don't think too hard.
Apples, I guess.
Apples?
Yeah, I love apples.
Okay. I was thinking more along the lines of carpentry or horses or something. All right, go work in an orchard then.
By that token, you must really like shooting and robbing people.
I only like shooting young idiots who run away from me when I'm trying to help them.
Father told me what you do.
I'm sure he did.
Hey, are you still with Dutch and what was his name? Hester?
Jose. Yep, still the same, sort of.
And Annabelle and Bessie?
I'm afraid they're dead.
Shit. Maybe Mary did make the right choice.
Here we are. Must be waiting inside.
We going in then?
Paul Square, I'm gonna use that too.
Jamie! Come home, please. Father's been very sad.
Father wouldn't know sadness if it died in his bed. But I'll come home for you.
My boy. My sweet boy. Come on.
Oh, hey, Meg, you okay?
Thank you. Thank you.
I finally got him.
It's good to see you, Mary.
And you, Arthur. And you. You'll never change. I know that.
Charming.
Luckiest man alive, and I feel like a fool. That woman confuses me and plays me for a fiddle like no one else alive. I trust I will not make a god-awful fool of myself once more, but somehow I imagine I shall.
Alright, any missions I can do in this area before I call it? No, I'm not travelling all the way down to that mission there. Not yet, at least. I think we'll leave it there for today for now, guys. If you enjoyed this video, please like it, and we'll get back to that today with all my content. Take care, guys. Peace out.